So this little chat is going to be on adding new materials to gpvdm. Now very often I get asked how to add new materials, and this is quite a common thing to want to do because you might have a new device with a new material and you want to sort of simulate this. So how do I include new N and K data in the model? So this chore is going to cover this. So here's an outline of the presentation. I'm just going to go through each one of these steps. So effectively we're going to talk about what material database is, adding materials, importing materials, and sort of stuff like that. So that's what it's going to be. You can access the materials database in the model by clicking on materials database and database tab, then clicking on the type of material you're interested in, say polymer or what have you, and then double click on whichever material you're interested in. And when you do that, you get up effectively absorption and refractive index. So the key, this whole presentation, this whole talk is going to be on how to effectively add new refractive indices and absorptions to this database. Now, this database is primarily a source or effective, it's primarily a, it contains refractive index data, so N and K data. It does not contain, we don't think of it as containing electrical data. Now, N and K data, I guess, don't vary so much between, how can I put this? When you make a device, say, of a P3HT, PCBM solar cell or something like that, it's very hard to know exactly what the mobility of the device is, how many traps there are, and how much disorder there is, and sort of recombination rates and things like that, because the thin film will vary very much depending which lab you which lab it's deposited in, the humidity, the batch material you used, the film thickness, who's doing the experiment, all these things sort of combine to make the fact that when you make a thin film of a disordered material, it's very hard to know what the mobility is of that film or any other electrical parameter. So therefore, this database only contains optical parameters, only contains N and K data. To sort of extract electrical, or to find out which electrical parameters you should be using, you should either look in the literature or you should try and fit the model to your experimental data, one of those. So this whole database is really about optical parameters. Now there are some, if you look in here, there are some electrical parameters in this database, but they're really just used for drawing sort of band structure and things like that. It's not actually used in the simulation itself. So now I've clarified that this is an optical database of materials, not an electrical database. We can continue. So where is materials database stored? So it's stored in your home directory. So if my username is Rod, it's going to be stored in users Rod gpvdm local materials. So it's in your gpvdm local directory, which is your home directory. If your home directory is stored somewhere else than other than the user directory or C drive, it'll be in the gpvdm local directory /backslash materials. So effectively look for gpvdm local in your home directory on your Windows PC, and then within that will be a directory called materials, and that is where the materials database is stored. What format is the materials database stored in? The materials database effectively is a collection of directories like this. So here's a directory called P3HT. Inside this directory there will be four files. There'll be a file called alpha.gmat, n.gmat, that should say bib.bib.bib. That should be called mat.bib and data.json. Alpha.gmat contains the optic absorption information, so that's basically absorption of material as a function of wavelength. N.gmat contains the real part, the refractive index, as a function of wavelength. Mat.bib is effectively a bibtex file that contains where the material came from, and data.json contains anything else. It's a JSON format file. You can Google what JSON, what format JSON is. It's just a text file that contains any other information. These are all text files. You can edit directly with Notepad or whatever you want, and you can directly change them, and you sort of mess with these files by hand if you want to. So here's an example of n.gmat, so that's say gmat. It's effectively just a column of X and Y data. And here is another, this is the alpha.gmat, and it's just a column of X and Y data. the file has is basically wavelengths in meters and refractive inverse refractive index. That's this n file, so the n refractive index. And this file is alpha.gmat, is wavelengths as a function of meters against absorption in meters to the minus one. Key thing to remember about these files is that they are all contain only have SI units in them. So the wavelength is in meters, wavelength is not in centimeters, not in nanometers, not in micrometers, it's in meters. Everything is in meters. Refractive index obviously has no units, it's arbitrary unit. And absorption is in meters to the minus one. It's not attenuation coefficient, it's absorption, which is measured in meters to the minus one. So if you get those right, you can replace these X and Y columns with whatever data you want, and you can more effectively model the optical parameters of any material. Adding your own data to the hard way. So first I'm going to go through adding your own data the hard way, and then we're going to do it the easy way. So the hard way first, so you understand. Basically, if you want to make a new material, just copy an existing file. So imagine you've got a file called p3ht, just copy this and call it something else like PMMA, okay? Then, effectively find some absorption data, so wavelength versus N, wavelength versus alpha, and all you want to do is effectively copy and paste that into these files. So you've got the n.gmat file, so have wavelength there, refractive index there, wavelength there, absorption there, and make sure it's all in the right units, and that's it, you're done. That's it, you just need to literally copy in the data, problem solved. Where do I get refractive index from, or refractive index data from? So where do you get your NNK data from? Your experiments, this is the best option. So if you've got an experiment where you're measuring NNK data for your particular film, use that, that's going to be best. Otherwise, you can use refractiveindex.info. This is a very good site containing lots of information on refractive indices. PV Lighthouse also got some. Also got NK data as well. Or you can extract the NK data from papers and literature. So I'm now going to show you how to do that. Extracting NNK data from literature. So imagine you've got some, here's a PDF of some paper. Basically, go find the paper you're interested in. Extract the graph that you're interested in, so here we've got the real part of N against wavelength. Extract this and save this as a picture. Now, you can use the editor, I'm on Linux, so I use the editor GIMP, which is very good. You can also use Paintbrush, so on Windows I'll press print screen on the keyboard, open up Paintbrush and press Control V, and you'll then be able to copy and paste this out of the screen and save it as a PNG file. Then, go to so this digitizer Engage is very, very good, and it's currently moved around a bit over the years, but its current website you can get it is this one on its GitHub page. But if not, just Google Engage Digitizer. It's very, very good. It enables you to effectively turn pictures like this back into real data. So what you do is you import it into this Engage software. You tell the software where the axes are, so you say 800 nanometers, 400 nanometers, and you put little red crosses where the axes are. Then with your mouse, go and discretize this graph by hand, and you click sort of export, and you can export the data, and then you've got X and Y data that can be imported into these files of N and alpha. And then basically save this as, and make sure the units are again in wavelength in meters, refractive index, or wavelength meters in absorption meters to minus one. And just copy and paste this data into the N and alpha files, and you're done. The only thing I'd say about this is make sure there's no commas or any weird formatting. Notice these files are wavelength. I should have done a bit more of a zoom in on this, but it's wavelength and then the number, new line, wavelength, and then there's no commas, there's nothing weird like that. Other thing to watch out for is on some computers, so in the English language, the decimal point is a full stop, and in some languages a comma. It may not handle a comma very, very well. So moving on. So you've done that. Now, using the graphical interface to import data. So you can sort of do this the hard way. You can copy files, import data by hand, or you can use graphical interface. So to do this, all you do is go materials, select the directory which you want to import the material in, click add material, and then you'll have made a new material. Double click on that and it'll bring up this window, which is effectively a blank material. And notice this has no data in the file. Then click import data. So this will effectively import data into the model. So click on that and it'll bring up this import tool. Open the data file containing your data. So this could be the data file you've exported from Engage. This could be one you've downloaded from Refractive Index or Info. This could be from your experiment, whatever it might be. And it will load it into this editor. Now, the key thing is, this is the, like, basically the raw data that you're importing. This here is the data that's effectively being transformed into gpvdm. The point of this window is that it effectively transforms data in any units to data in units that gpvdm can understand. So any units mean things like things in centimeters, things in attenuation coefficients, things in nanometers, and it will transform all that into SI units. So to do that, all you need to do is, in these boxes here, select what the X column is and what the Y column is. So if your X column is in nanometers, select nanometers here, and it will transform into meters. If your Y column is in attenuation coefficient, it will then transform into absorption in meters to minus one. So basically, the key thing to remember is select these boxes to be whatever your original data is in, and then transform it into what gpvdm can read. Then after you've done that, just click import data and it'll import it into the model. And there you go, that's it, it's that simple. So other information contained within the Imperial's material database. You've got some basic electrical information. Now by this basic electrical information, I mean it's got things like the electron affinity and the band gap. These are not used in the simulation. These are just used to draw a band diagram. So don't worry about those really. Thermal information, it's got things like, it's got some thermal information that's in this materials database. This again is not used in the simulation, but it can be imported to the simulation. And you've got some other basic information like the colour of the material and stuff like that. All this data is stored, so all these windows here, the information in these windows, is stored in this file, data.json. And this is a JSON file, so a JSON file, you can read about what that is on the internet. It's just basically a text file with some like sort of, you know, it's just a special format text file. And you can open this using Firefox, or you can edit it directly by hand, and you sort of change it by hand, or you can use this editor to change these values, it's up to you. I've talked about this, basically I've said that this database is primarily a database, optical materials, not electrical materials, not optical properties, because the films change so much as they're fabricated. So there's a zoom in of the basic information, so you set the colour and things like that, the material, thermal conductivity and stuff like that, and that's it. So, hope you found that useful. That's effectively how to add materials to the material database. If anything's unclear about this, let me know. I'll update the little slide deck, and you'll be able to find this on the website. So thank you very much.